four, three, two, one. Boys and girls, it's time! With a record of helping over 1,000 students in math, Coach Seifel's here. So let's get ready to rumble!
What's up, everybody? What's up? Woo! We are towards the last stretch towards the PSLE. We are at the last stretch towards the PSLE, and we are very close. How close are we? Can you all type into the box? How many days away are we from the PSLE, math paper? Whew. All right. I don't know why I'm winded today, but I'm excited because today we're going to go through problem sums. For the first time, we're going to go into problem sums, not just the basic ones, okay? So I've chosen a few questions from the 2013 all the way to 2015 questions. Questions that you won't probably see anywhere else because it's no longer in print, right? So basically the idea is that I'm going to go through questions that you will never see. I mean, you will not see, you cannot find anywhere else. You will already know 2017, 2018, and 2019, correct? Yeah. So these are some questions that are interesting. All right, so we are 31 days away, correct, right? We are 31 days away from the PSLE math paper. We are 31 days away from the PSLE, but we are 32 days away from the PSLE math paper. So we've got about 1 month plus left, right? We are very close towards the end, and I'm hoping that you guys are excited because we have to end strong, all right? I'm on episode 9 of this program. We've got one last episode next week, and then we're done, all right? Then I'm going to be focusing my class on all my students at the center. I've got about 50 of them, PSLE students. All right, so let's begin. Everybody, as usual, we are always mentioning, number one, there will be no spam, right? Number two, do not post GIFs, photos, whatever in the chat. Number three, do not post anything irrelevant. And if you see someone saying something that is irrelevant, don't say the word irrelevant or start a fight with someone, okay? Just simple as that, okay? If not, you will be banned, as usual, as always, all right? Okay, so let's begin, guys. I'm going to share with you my screen. Hi, everybody. Hello. Hi, I see a lot of people are here. Very good. Today, we have about, not many. Today, we got 70 only, right? So, numbers are dwindling. It's okay. We are towards the end anyway. So, you guys who are staying with me, you guys, I think, have a better chance at scoring a lot better than those who have stopped halfway, okay? So, guys, hi to everyone. Yes, hi to all of you. I think your prelims, your results are out, right? Some of your prelims are easy. Some of your prelims are difficult. It really depends on your school. Before I start, do me a favor, guys. Can you please like and share this video? Do that for me first, all right? Help me like and share this video. Whatever result that you get for your prelims, right, is usually not really important. To be honest with you, I don't even remember what's my prelim results. I don't even remember taking the prelims, okay? That's how insignificant or unimportant that is, okay? The more important part, guys, is that you guys got to focus on the future, which is the PSLE. That's the only one that matters. So if you did very well for the prelims, don't say like, yeah, I did a good job, yay, right? And then you like you get very overconfident, and then you do, some students do poorly for the PSLE that way. On the other hand, there are students who also do poorly for the prelims, then they get very discouraged. Now, instead of doing that, you can actually work your butt off, right, for the next 31 days to make sure that you score at the end for the PSLE, and then you can go like, and his name is John Cena. He's like, yeah. All right, so the PSLE results day, that's what I want you to happen to you. Okay, so there's a like button, there's a share button. As usual, if you, those of you who are my OGs, you all would know, there's like a little button there that looks like this, right? If you cannot see it, not clear, click on that, click on quality, click on 720p or 720 pixels, right? They can get very clear, clear working, clear vision. Okay, So the first one, I'm going to go through whole numbers. These are all the MCQs and the paper ones. I want to focus on the questions that I believe will come out, or at least a higher chance of coming out for the PSLE. Okay, so let's take a look at one of these. I'm going to go into level, is that level three? Let me start with level two questions first. Okay, let's start with a level two question first. Let's start with this first, guys. At a bakery, Jen paid $12.40 for a banana cake and 4 egg tarts. She paid $25.20 for a banana cake and 20 egg tarts. Rani bought 5 banana cakes. How much did she pay? All right. Looks like a very leche, very troublesome kind of question. So please go ahead, guys. Let me give you like about 2 minutes. Can you please try the question? This is paper two. You can see that as paper two over here on the bottom right-hand corner. That means you can use the calculator. All right. So please go ahead. Give it a shot. Ignore the ice cream man if you can hear in the background. Click, 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 click. Yes, familiar question, Jaira. Yeah, give it a shot, guys. If you've seen the question before, please go ahead. Just give it a shot. Should be quite simple. Just warm up for your brain. You got about 30 seconds left. Oh, very good. I see a lot of you are already putting in the answers and they are all right. Very good. So that tells me that you guys are good at this particular method. Huh? Very good. Yeah, awesome. Okay, so I think that's a good warm up. Everybody is like quite confident with this question. The answer is correct. I think so far I've not seen any other answer except for 46. So good job. The answer is correct, everybody. You are a math prodigy.
That was easy.
Okay, so basically this one is called the elimination method, right? So how you can do it is you can do it using, let me just show you what I mean. You can use like this method where you go one banana cake plus 4 egg tarts equals to 1240, right? So this is called elimination method. Now, how do I know it's an elimination method? It's because I have two items, right? And two different values of the item. Here's one banana cake, here's 4 egg tarts, adding up to 1240. And the other one is banana cake and 20 egg tarts adding up to 2520, right? So that's how you know that it's going to be elimination method. So it will be one banana cake and 20 egg tarts equal to 2520. So now here's the thing, guys. If they ask you for egg tarts, right? What am I writing? If they're asking you for egg tarts, right? You have to eliminate which one? Banana cakes. If they ask you for banana cake, you must eliminate which one? You must eliminate the egg tarts. So which is why I'm going to multiply this by 5. This will be the shortest way that you can do, right? So I multiply by 5, I will get the answer of, let me just write down below here. 5 banana cakes plus 20 egg tarts equals to $62, right? $62. From there, you minus off this one. I put it below so that I don't confuse myself, right? Which will give me the answer of 2520. Now you just minus them off, guys. So 5B minus 1B will give me 4 banana cakes, right? 20 egg tarts, cancel, eliminated, right? 62 minus 2520 will give me 3680. So this is the answer for 4 banana cakes. But we want 5 banana cakes, remember? So we divide by 4, we times 5, right? So that'll be easy. So 1 banana cake would be 920 divided by 4, right? So 5 banana cakes would be, multiply that by 5, right? So 920 times 5 will give me the answer of $46. Good job. So a lot of you got the answer. I am very happy with that. Awesome. That was easy, right? That was really easy.
So there's many ways you can do it. That will be the method that I choose. Let's move on to the next question. Let's do something slightly more challenging. Let me see what I can choose for you. All right. So this one I remember was quite challenging. But let me just hold on. Don't do it first. Don't do it first. Let me try first. Yeah, let's try this one. And those of you who are in my PSLE intensive program, you probably have gone through this before. Just make sure that you try it again and see whether you got the answer correct. Okay, doesn't matter that you're doing it one more time. Hopefully it refreshes the memory for you. So this is also, this is a paper one question, however, question 15. So it's a 2-mark question. So let's give you 2 minutes to solve this one. Okay, ready, set, go. So I see some of you are giving answers already. Let's take a look. Is the answer correct? Let me check for you guys. Oh, that was fast. Good job, everybody. Is it just me or are these questions like too easy for you guys? I am surprised, actually. Those of you who are still doing it, you've got about 20 seconds more to go. All right. Time's up. Okay, so I saw a lot of your answers. Most of you said the answer was 3, and the answer is correct. Your answer is 3. Good job. All right, so that was easy. Now, let me just play for you the thing.
That was easy.
Very simple. Very, very simple. Okay, so the answer is 3. Now, why is it 3? Now, let's read the question, okay? Ling and Junie made greeting cards over 2 days. On Saturday, Ling made 19 more cards than Junie. So let's draw the model first, right? For me, I would use models because that's how I see things easily, right? Ling, what happened there? Ling made 19 more cards than Junie. So you see, you got 19 over, you got 19 over here. And Junie is this part from here to here, right? That's the start. Now, what happened after that? Ling made another 20 cards. So Ling would make another 20 cards and Junie would make another 15 cards. So we draw the model, extend the model a bit. So we have 20 over here, let's say, right? Then we have 15 over here, let's say, roughly. Should be a bit smaller. It's okay. Then after that, they found out what? That at the end of the 2 days, Ling made 3/5 of the total number of cards. Now, that would mean what? If Ling made 3/5, it means that Ling made 3 units, right? Ling made 3 units. And the total number of cards would be 5, okay? This, if you all attended my master problem sum, you would know this is called the A over B. So Ling made 3 out of the total number, which is 5. Now that tells you what? If Ling made 3 and total was 5, it means that Junie made 5 minus 3, right? She made 2 units worth. So in other words, right, guys, if I draw the model back, it will be like that. 1, 2, oh, this is very bad. Hold on. 1, 2, 3, roughly here, right? And Junie would be from here to here only, 2 units. Okay? So we can tell that, guys, the difference will be 1 unit worth. That means that the difference between here and here must also be the 1 unit. So what we do is we take 20 plus 19, we minus off the 15, right? Simple. So let's do that. 20 plus 19 will be 39. 39 minus 15 will give you 24. So I'm just going to write this down, 24. So this is 24. So 1 unit is 24. So what was the number of cards that Junie made? Junie made 2 units, right? So 24 times 2. So the answer is 48. That was easy. Okay, cool. All right, let's move on to try the next question. So since you all are finding it easy, right, guys, I'm going to switch it up a bit. Let's look at something that is slightly more challenging, okay? I'm going to look at question number 9. Is it number 9? No, this one, I think from what I understand, is no longer in the PSLE thing anymore. Let's try this one. This is an interesting one. Number 10. Ray bought 150 oranges and 100 apples for her neighbors. So basically, I'm going to help you out a bit by highlighting for you. 150 oranges, 100 apples, right? She divided the oranges equally. Keyword is equally among them and had 17 oranges left. Oops, sorry. She also divided the apples equally among them. So apples were also divided equally among them and had 5 apples left. How many neighbors were there? This is an interesting question. Let's give it a shot, guys. This is a 2-mark question. Okay, so let's give you 2 minutes. Let me mute my background because there's people talking in the background. Okay, now that my neighbors have walked past. Okay, so you got about 40 more seconds. So far, I've seen some answers. Some people say 13. Some people say, I think 19 right now. 19? Maybe. I don't know. I won't tell you yet. So it looks like the class is divided. Yeah? Some people saying 13. Some people say 19. Let's see which is the answer. You got about 3 seconds left. All right, time's up. So what is the answer, guys? Is it 13 or is it 19? I think more than half of you said 13, but slightly less than half of you said 19. The answer is... drum roll. 19. Ding. Okay, so the answer is 19. Good job, guys.
That was easy.
Okay, so how do you get 19, right? So let's go through this question together. Okay, so this one is a tough one. I'm surprised that a lot of you got the answer correct. Okay, good job. I'm really impressed. Okay, so the idea is this. If Ray bought 150 oranges, right? And she divided them equally. Remember that she said that, what happened? For the oranges, did she distribute everything? The answer is no, right? Because she had 150 oranges. And then at the end, she had 17 oranges left. So that tells me that she gave away only how many? 150 minus 17, right? So that will give you the answer of 133. So 133 oranges were given out. That's that one. Okay, clear. Okay, step two, we also take a look at the apples, and the apples were not fully divided, right? There were some left, and there were five apples left, which means that not all of them were distributed equally. Some of them were actually like left over, right? So that means we have 133 oranges, right? And 95 apples that were given out to a number of people, a number of neighbors. So that's the one, that's our job. We're supposed to find out how many neighbors were there, right? So when you think of it, right, this one is a question about what? Common, what? Common factor or common multiple? What's the answer, guys? Is it common factor or common multiple? The answer is actually common factor, right? Common factor. So let's break it up. Actually, multiple also can lah. Actually, the same thing, right? Because we are going to break it up into factor anyway. Let's give it a shot, okay? Actually, it's a common factor, sorry, not common multiple. So 133 and 95, okay? So let's take the oranges here and 95 apples here. So eventually, we need to find a number, right, guys, that can be divided equally among these two fruits, right? So 133 oranges basically will be 1 times 133. 2 cannot, 3 cannot, 4 cannot, 5 cannot. You keep trying, right, until you reach a number. You keep dividing until you get 7, right? 7 times 19. Okay, how about 95 apples? So same thing, 1 times 95. We can do 5 times... 5 times what? 9. Hold on, let me calculate. 5 times 19, right, I think? 5 times 19. 19 times 5 will give me... Yeah, correct, 95. So it's 5 times 19. So you can see, guys, that there is a number that is common, right? 19. 19 here, 19 here. What does that mean? That means that I can divide these numbers equally among 19 neighbors. And each neighbor will get 7 oranges and 5 apples. All right? So that is how you find the answer to this question. This is a common factor question. Right? Common factor. All right. I think you all are pretty good. Huh? That's pretty good. I'm so surprised, actually. Good job, guys. Really good. Really good. Okay. Hold on. Something is wrong with my Zoom. Okay. Let's carry on. So, next question. I've chosen something here, which is, I would say, not so bad. Hold on, I'm thinking about whether I should check this one or that one. Okay, you know what? This is actually quite a simple one. So we backtrack a bit. But I want to see whether y'all can do. Because I know that a lot of my students are somehow, for some reason, keep forgetting how to do this question. And it tends to come out quite a bit during the PSLE, which is question number 3. This one. Okay? So can you all please give this a shot? Number 3. Then that's it. I'm going to move on to ratio and percentage. I'm going to basically jump around. So basically what I see, questions that are not so, a lot of students have problems with, I will go through that one. Okay, so same thing. This is booklet 1. Booklet 1, paper A. Okay, so it's a 2-mark question. So let's give you 2 marks. 2 minutes. Let's go. Shakira, why is it 32? There's no 32 option in this question. Okay, got it. D- those of you who are still doing, you got about 30 more seconds. Those of you who are in the PSLE intensive program, you better get this one correct, okay? Just this weekend, some of you, I tested you on this and you all got it wrong, okay? So this is a very important one that you must know. It is called the remainder pothole concept. All right, time's up. Okay, let's go through. The answer is... Okay, wait. Let me check first what's the answer. I don't even know. Okay, so a lot of you put 4. A lot of you put 4. And guess what, guys? Is that correct? The answer is, drum roll. If you put option number 4, the answer is incorrect. The answer is actually option number 3. This is the answer. Okay, that's why I wanted to give you guys this question to see whether you can do it. The answer is option number 3. First of all, you got it correct.
That was easy.
Okay.
Excellent.
Okay, so how do we do this question? Okay, the answer is option number 3, which is 72. Okay, so let's take a look. A shop had a number of computers for sale now after selling 32. So they sold 32 in the morning already. Okay, and 5 out of 8 of the remainder in the afternoon. Now, the moment if you know is the words of the remainder, there should be one method that comes to your mind straight away, which is what? Which is your branching method. However, right, there is also a method that has the words of the remainder, and it also has something like this: left with 1/4 of the computers or total number, right? You know straight away this is going to be a remainder part whole concept. Okay, this is called the remainder part whole concept. Okay, so what's the remainder part whole concept? Remainder part whole concept means that you have already sold a part of it and there's some remainder. So in this case, after selling 32, right? So I'm going to draw a model. Let's say this model represents 32, okay? 32. Now, what happens is there's also 5 out of 8 of the remainder. That means that there are 8 units, because there's this denominator, there are 8 units of what? Of remainder. And 5 of them were sold in the afternoon. So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to draw a bit longer here. Okay, so let's say I subdivide it to 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Right? Okay. Okay, watch that, guys. Watch that. So this 32, is it gone? Gone, right? It's sold. Sold. Okay, then what happens? There is 5 out of 8 were also sold in the morning. So that means that we have to subdivide 5. 1, 2, 3. Sorry, not subdivide. We have to shed 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And now we are left with how many, guys? We are left with 3 units left. Now, correct. These 3 units represents 1/4 of the total computers. So think about it this way. Excuse me. If you think about it this way, 1/4 of the computers is equal to how many units? 3 units. So the whole thing, the whole number of computers, right, will be 4 out of 4 total number, which is 3 times 4. So the total is going to be 12 units. Now that tells me what? That tells me that this whole thing, right, is supposed to be 12 units. You got it, guys? So that tells me also that if the ones on the right here, okay, let me erase one. The ones on the right, they are 8, right? I see this now. There were 8 units. And the total are supposed to be how many? 12 units. This 32 is going to be how many? 12 minus 8, right? So the answer would be 4 units. So now we know, that means that the 4 units are equal to the 32. Now you might tell me, hey, but coach, why is the 4 units longer than the 8 units? Or, almost the same size as the 8 units. And the answer is because I don't know at the start how many units that represents, right? But as long as you understand that there's going to be 4 units, that's fine already, okay? So 1 unit is 32 divided by 4, which is equal to 8. And what was the question, guys? What was the question? The question is, how many computers were sold all together. So that means that we have already sold 32 over here. Don't forget. Plus 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So that means 5 units would be 8 times 5, giving you the answer of 40. Don't forget the 32 at the back. So 40 plus 32. Oops, sorry. 40 plus 32 will give you 72, right? So that's the answer, option number 3. Okay?
It's over 9,000!
Okay, cool. All right, so someone's asking, why are we doing MCQ? This one is really, actually comes out for word problems as well, right? This is considered a word problem, but it's a word problem that was put into the MCQ. So that's what I'm going through anyway, right? No problem. Let's carry on. Let's carry on. Okay, so everyone okay, right? All right, cool. So we are going to move on to the next topic. I'm going to skip some of these because these are quite simple. I checked already. I'm going to move on to ratio and percentage, something that I think a lot of you have a problem with. Hey, where's my ratio and percentage? Wait, guys. Ah, there you go. All right, so I want to go through some questions from, let me see, this one you all tried before, right? Where's my LEL tree? Okay, this one, let's give this one a shot. I know this looks simple, but I don't know why, for some reason, some students have a hard time with this one. Okay, let's give it a shot, guys. Let's try this one. Number 7, Mrs. Wong bought a rice cooker for $126 after a discount of 30%. Okay, so I put it up for you. 126, she bought it for 126 after a discount of 30%. Okay. Part A, what was the price of the rice cooker before the discount? Price of rice cooker before discount. And part B, she paid $40 for a toaster. The total discount for the rice cooker and a toaster was $64. What was the percentage discount given for the toaster? Okay. So give it a shot. This one is actually going to be a bit more than then 2 marks, if I'm not mistaken. It should be 1 and 2. Eh, where's the mark? Okay, never mind. I'll find for you. Where is my marking scheme? Yeah, it's 1 and 2 marks. Yeah? So it's 1 and 2. So let's give you about 4 minutes to solve this question. It will take a bit more time. This one, can you use calculator or not? Is this paper 2? Yes, you can use calculator. The part A should be quite simple. The part B is the one that I think some people have problems with. Excuse me. Wow, that was fast. Some of you got the answers already. You sure not, guys? Check the answer first before you stop trying again. Check your working, I mean, not check your answer. Mm-hmm. You got 30 seconds left, guys. 30 seconds. Okay, so I think we are almost done. All right, time's up, time's up. Okay, answer, answer. Let's take a look at your answers. Okay, I think a lot of you got answer correct. Good job. So I see that part A is very simple. A lot of you got answer 180. There's no problem, right, guys? Shouldn't be a problem at all. Mrs. Wong bought a rice cooker for 126 after a discount of 30%. That means that the 126 must be 70%, right? So, okay, hold on. 70% would be $126, right? So your before discount will be your 100%, right? So to make it fast for you, 126 divided by 70 times 100, okay? So you get straight away the answer of $180. So part A, that was easy, right? Super, super simple.
That was easy.
Okay, so you must get the first one correct, guys, without any problems, okay? Now, part B is the one that I know that I saw a lot of different answers, but most of you put in the answer of 20%, which is correct.
That was easy. Excellent.
I love that one.
Excellent.
Okay, all right, cool. All right, cool. No, I'm not punching you. Okay, that's called Rocky. All right, so answers. Good job, guys. You all got 20%. Let's go through the question. Why is it 20%? I saw some of you got 25%. Some of you got, I don't know, what? Some people got like 60%, 10%, right? So let's go through this one. So they said that she paid $40 for a toaster, right? The total discount for the rice cooker and the toaster was $64. Now, so basically the rice cooker is also part of the purchase, right? So there's a rice cooker and there is a toaster. So for the rice cooker, right, guys? The idea is we need to find out what was the discount given first. So if you recall, the price was 126 over here, right? And the original price was 180. That means the discount for the rice cooker itself is 180 minus 126, correct? Minus 126. So I will get the answer of $54, correct? $54. Now, $54 was for the rice cooker, the RC. Right, that means the toaster, if the total was $64, the toaster would have a discount of how much? It's 64 minus $54, correct? Because the $54 belonged to the discount of the rice cooker. So you were only given a $10 discount for the toaster. So what's the question? What was the percentage discount for the toaster? Now, this is the reason why I'm doing the question. I want to make sure all of you know this. The formula for percentage discount. Percentage discount. Okay. What's the formula? The formula is discount over what? Original. Okay. Over original times 100%. Now, this formula works for everything like percentage decrease or percentage increase, right? Would be either the decrease or the increase over original times 100%. Okay, so I need you all to remember this because this is quite important for the exam, all right? So from there, what we can do is we can find out. The discount we know is $10, right, guys? Now, a lot of students who got the answer wrong wrote down the original as $40. That is incorrect because you recall the original price is not $40. That was the price they paid after the discount. So the original price would be 40 plus 10 because the discount plus the discounted price will give you the original price. Times 100%. So the answer would be 10 out of 50, which is 1 out of 5, right? Which is 20%. And that is how we get the answer. Ding! Hey, where's my ding sound? All right. Okay, very good. Those of you got answer correct. Good job. Good job. All right. Hey, this boy, Mr. Naufal, can you please stop making things like up? Just don't make it more noisy. Okay, just ignore everything. Focus on the math. Okay. All right, let's go on to the next question. Okay, so guys, this member, the answer is you gotta do percentage discount. All right, so I wanna do one more that I think tends to still come up for the PSLE, which is question number 6. Anyway, don't worry about people copying your answer. It doesn't even matter, to be honest with me. Honest with you, if they go copy it, then they don't get the answer correct, then it's fine. It's their fault, right? So the idea is just do it yourself, okay? No problem. Okay, so let's try question number 6, guys. Gerald was given a fixed amount of pocket money each month, okay? Now, in January, he spent $50 and saved the rest. Okay. In February, he spent 10% less and his savings increased by 25%. Okay. Now, this is the thing that I want to explain to you guys. Okay. Let me just write down first. First thing, fixed amount. Each month, he's getting a fixed amount of money. Now, I don't know how much you guys get for your pocket money, but I know that last time when I was your age, right, I maybe got like a dollar or two. I can't remember exactly. Maybe a dollar when I was primary school. Yeah. In January, he spent $50 and saved the rest. Okay. In February. Okay. So this January. Yeah. So in February, he spent 10% less and his savings increased by 25%. Question. How much was Gerald's pocket money for each month? Okay, let's give you this question. The question is worth 2 marks. It's a paper 2 question, so you can use the calculator. Let's give you about 3 minutes. Let's give 3 minutes. Wow, that was fast. Some of you got answer already. Wow. Some of you are like super flash, man. Okay, so far I'm seeing answers and the answers I believe are incorrect. Wow, so many put 65. Sure. Is my answer sheet wrong? Or maybe you were wrong. Okay, those of you who got 65, right? I have a feeling that you're wrong. Okay, please try again. See, is there anything that is mistaken or something? We got 5 more seconds, guys. 5 more seconds. All right. Time's up. Okay. So let's check the answer. What is the answer? So I saw a lot of you got $65. The answer is unfortunately incorrect. Okay. The answer is actually $70.
Excellent. That was easy.
Okay. So those of you who got 65, let's go through and take a look. Okay. Those of you who got 70, good job. All right. Now, Gerald was given a fixed amount of pocket money each month. Now, when it comes to PSLE math, right? I don't know, like, okay, based on what we've seen so far, you can only do 2 things with your money. You can either spend it or you can save it. Of course, you guys are smarter. You know that that's not what happens. You can spend it. You can save it. You can donate it. You can use it to form a business, right? You can invest it, right? There's a lot of things you can do, guys. But remember, in the PSLE context, there's only 2 things you can do, which is you can spend it. If you don't spend it, you will save it. So get that right first. I repeat, if you don't spend it, if you don't spend it, what will happen? You will basically save it, right? That's the whole idea. All right, cool. So now let's try the question now. In January, he spent $50 and saved the rest. So let me write this down for you. In January, so let's put that as spend versus save, okay? So how much did he spend? He spent $50. Do we know how much he saved? We don't, right? So just put it as spend and save. Now, in February, what happens? He spent 10% less. So now, if he spent 10% less, how much is that? Okay, so when you spend 10% less, remember, your original is always 100%. So 100% minus 10% will give you 90%, right? So basically, you have to find out what's 90% of 50, right? So let me write this down as 90 out of 100 multiplied by 50. 1, 2, 9, 90 divided by 2 is 45. So the answer is $45, right? So you spend $45. Okay, anyone clear under here? So what happens is that we have spent $50 in January, but in February, he spent how much? 10% less, which is $45. However, what happened, guys? As a result of that, his savings increased by 25%. Now, remember something. If you don't spend it, what happens? You save it. Now, what happened was to the spending? It decreased by how much, guys? By $5. So I repeat, if you don't spend the $5, what happens? You save the $5. Now, that means that his savings are going to increase by $5. Y'all get it? This is the most important part, okay? I repeat, if you don't spend the $5, you would save the $5. And that $5 represents what, guys? It represents this part. It represents an increase by 25%. That means the $5 must be equal to the 25%. You get it now? So the idea is, if 25% is equal to the $5, right? Oops, sorry. 25% is equal to the $5. That means that to find the original savings, it will be 100%, right? So 100% would be, multiplied by 4, like basically, because 25 times 4 will give me 100, right? So I times 4, I will get 20. Okay, so the idea is 100% is 20. Okay, so that means that this number would be $20. All right, so, wait a minute, sorry. $20 is the original, then you must plus 5, so 25, my mistake, sorry. And if you want to remember that the 100% is 20, that would be over here. So that's the $20. Okay. So that would be the answer. 50 plus 20 is 70. Or you can do 45 plus 25 will also give you $70. Okay. So that is how you find the answer to this question. Can you type to the box? That was easy. Everybody, type to the box. That was easy.
That was easy. Excellent.
Excellent. Okay, so where did I get the $5? It's 50 minus 45. Okay, remember, if you didn't spend, remember you said, if you don't spend the because I said decrease by 10%, remember? So that was the 10%. Lah. This is 10% decrease. Let me write down here, okay? 10, sorry. Okay, let me write clearly for you. This is the 10% decrease. Alrighty, good job. Let's move on to the next question. That was not easy, really. Okay, so those of you who found it easy, right? That's great. Those of you who didn't find it easy, then now you know a new method. And this one keeps getting asked. Lah. Like, if you don't save it, then you spend it, right? That's the whole idea. Okay, let's do one last question, guys, before we move on to another topic. Today, I mean, intend to do four topics, lah, because I have two parts to this problem solving. Basically, it's this week and next week, and then we're done, guys. That's my last lesson with you next week. Feel sad that that will be the ending, but I really have to focus my energy on my students who are at the center also, right? So I'll focus on that. So our last lesson will be next week. And before we leave, it's okay. We're going to move on to a question here. Let's try one last question. Let me see. This is a tricky one. Number 8. Okay, one last one before we call it. Before we take a break, sorry. Let's give you 3 minutes for this. This is a paper 2 question. You may use the calculator. So Arlene, hello. So Arlene, basically for next time when what's that called? When I say for the students at the center, those of you who are my PSLE intensive students, right? We will meet on Monday online, right? So we can do extra classes. Wow, some of you got answer already, so fast. So I see some answers coming in. Some of you got 1540, some of you got 1520. Very strange that, very strange that some of you got different answers. Check again, guys. Please check again. Yes, this is a PSLE question. Came out in 2014. All right, time's up. Okay, let's go through the question now. Okay, so Sunshine Reader book sale. First book at 10% discount, second book at 20% discount. Now, I don't know about you, but if you were a book reader, right, and you see this, I mean, if you're a reader, right, and then you come into the sale and you see first book at 10% discount, second book at 20% discount, right, you might be very happy, right? However, there is a clause. What's a clause? Not Santa Claus, okay? A clause is basically what? It means that it's a condition. And the condition is the price of the second book should be equal to or lower than the price of the first book. Now let's just think of it from the Sunshine Reader shop point of view, right? Why is it that they want to be the price of the second book to be equal or lower? Because if they were to give this for the higher, they will basically be losing a lot more money. You get what I mean? So for example, if I buy a $10 book, my second book, let's say $20, what happens? I will get a 20% discount, which is $4 discount for this one. I only get a $1 discount for the first one. But of course, the owner is very smart. He says that the second book must be the equal or lower price than the first book. That means he's saying now, it cannot be treated as the first book. As the second book, it must be treated as the first book. You get what I mean? So that means that the first book must be the more expensive one. So you only get a $2 discount, right? And here you get a $2 discount, right? So as a result, what will happen is you will save, he will save money on the back end, basically. All right. So Kim and Hao each bought two books at a sale. Kim's books were priced at $8 and $10. How much did she pay for them? So idea is which one is the first and which one is the second? Remember, the second book has to be lower than the price of the first book. So that means that we are going to take this book as the second book and this one as the first book. Question, how much did she pay for them? Right? So the idea is very simple. We are going to calculate for the second book as 20% discount, which means we are going to calculate 100 minus 20, which is 80% of the original price. For the first one, we're going to be looking at 90%, right? Because 100 minus 10%. So we will just simply add up the numbers together, which is for the first book, we are paying 90%. So 90 out of 100 times 10. Okay. So we get $9. Okay. And for the second book, we are basically doing 80%, right? 80 out of 100. Times, what's the price again? $8, right? So $8. So we cancel 8 out of 10 times 8, we will get the answer of $6.40. So as a result, the answer will be, if you pay together for them, 9 plus 640. Okay, so the answer will be $15.40. Those of you who got the answer correct, good job. Awesome. The answer is?
Was easy.
$15.40. Okay, so how much did she pay for that? She paid $15.40. I think some of you misread the question, did not see that the second book has to be cheaper than the first. Okay, so that's important. And that will be the end of the first half of this lesson. Let's take a short break, guys. When we come back, we shall resume on the next part. Okay. So now we've got 15:20. I don't know what happened. Can you all check? I think you made a careless mistake somewhere. Let's take a 10-minute break. Let me put a timer for you guys here. 10 minutes starts now. 10 or 5? 5, right? 5-minute break, sorry. 5-minute break. 5 minutes starts now. Put a timer. Okay, so normally we put 5 minutes or 10 minutes. I can't remember. 5, right?
Me pumps, zoo, 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 zoo. Me pumps, after cousin, yum, yum, yum. Me pumps, zoo, 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 zoo. Me pumps, after cousin, yum, yum, yum. Thank you. Mi fa zu 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 zu. Mi fa afkakus niam niam niam. Mi fa zu 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 zu. Mi fa afkakus niam niam niam. Mi fa zu 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 zu. Mi fa afkakus niam niam niam.
She said she too young, don't want no man. So she gon' call her friends, and that's a plan.
Black leather glove, no sequins. Buckles on the jacket, it's elite. Nike crossbody, got a piece in. Gotta dance, but it's really on some street. I'ma show you how to get it. It go right foot up, left foot slide. Left foot up, right foot slide. Basically, I'm saying either way, we bout to slide. Hey, can't let this one slide. Hey. Don't you wanna dance with me? No, I could dance like Michael Jackson. I could give you the passion. It's a thriller in a track. Where we from? Baby, don't you wanna dance with me? No, I could dance like Michael Jackson. I could give you satisfaction. And you know we out here every day with it. I'ma show you how to get it. It go right foot up, left foot slide. Left foot up, right foot slide. Basically, I'm saying either way, we bout to slide. Hey, can't let this one slide. Hey. 2,000 shorties wanna tie the knot, hey, yeah. 200 on my brother's block, oh, yeah. Pedal off a rose like I love or not, maybe not. I don't know what's wrong with me, I can't stop, oh, yeah. Won't stop, oh, yeah. Never stop. Got so many ops, I be mistaken ops for other ops. Got so many people that I love out of trouble spots. Other than the family, I gotta see the you and me. That's just how I think, it's either you and me. This life got too deep for you, baby. Two or three of us about to creep where they staying. Black leather glove, no sequins. Buckles on the jacket, it's elite. Nike crossbody, got a piece in. Gotta dance, but it's really on some street. I'ma show you how to get it. It go right foot up, left foot slide. Left foot up, right foot slide. Basically, I'm saying either way, we bout to slide. Hey, can't let this one slide. Hey.
Ten, nine, eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one. Boys and girls, it's time! With a record of helping over 1,000 students in math, Coach Seifel's here. So let's get ready to rumble!
What's up, everybody? Hope you had a good break. I just realized that you guys actually had 10 minutes for break. I thought it was 5 minutes. Anyway, just want to share with you guys that I'm actually posting a lot of questions onto the PSLE, I mean, about the PSLE 2019 paper on my TikTok. Okay, so basically you can see that I'm putting up all these things, yeah? And I've explained every single question. So just in case you all, in the future, you all miss like the lessons, you can go to the TikTok and basically look through the questions. I find it very strange that one of these, right? Let me show you. This question number one is so simple.
You'll be looking at this, right? Question from the PSLE 2019 paper number one in the number 43.21.
It's so simple, right, guys? But the idea, I don't know why, but they had like 175,000 people watching this video. I think the easier the questions are on TikTok, the easier, the more people will actually watch it, right? It's crazy. This one had 99,000 views. Crazy, crazy. Okay, so let's go back to our questions, guys. Let's go to our question on here. Okay, so we ended here just now, right? I want to continue on one last question. Oh, wait, before I do that, I have to say something. I want to congratulate someone in this group who has been working very hard. I know a lot of you work very hard, but I don't know your stories, right? So do me a favor, guys. If you all did very well for the prelims and you did, or maybe you improve a lot, can you post in the group later? Not? Ask your parents to post in the group. I want to hear your success stories. So this one is from Nur Jahan. Okay, so this is actually Isaac's mom, right? So Isaac, can you say hi so that everyone knows who you are? Okay, please just put there hi. Okay, and then put your name lah. Hi, I'm Isaac. Okay, so Isaac actually improved quite a bit. So the mom says this. Can you all see that message? Very hard to see. Okay, then I read for you. I want to say a very big thank you for the guidance and help from day one. I am so happy and thankful that Isaac got full score, full marks for his math MCQ. Whoa, good job, Isaac. Yay. Awesome. So for you, I will play one song. Good job, Isaac. All right, good job. It's the first time ever scoring full marks for it. Very, very excited for you because you know, I hope that you work harder for the PSLE and do a lot better than what you can if you normally have. Okay, so really, really happy for you. Good job. And again, like I said, if any of you you have actually done a lot better for this after going through this back to basics program, I mean the PSLE crash course, please ask your mom or dad to post onto the Facebook group, right? Later, or you can even post it yourself, right? Tell us how you did. That would be great. Yeah, that would be great. Okay, so let's go through the question. Oh, I see someone also got score full marks here. Very good, Salman. Good job. All right, so let's go through the question. Number 9. Okay, Chi Seng has a number of 10 cent, 20 cent, and 50 cent coins in the ratio 5:2:1. The total value of all the coins is $168. What is the total value of the 20 cent coins? Okay, do me a favor, guys. Let's give you about, this is a paper 2 question. You can use calculator. Let's give you 2 minutes for this, okay? Ready, set, go. I saw that message. We can call him Isaac Newton now. That's quite funny. Isaac, you know who's Isaac Newton? You know, right? He's quite a mathematician. He's quite a scientist. Yeah. All right, so I see some answers coming in already. 48, 42. Some of you are divided among the answer. Some people say 42, some people say 48. Which one is it? And the answer is one of them. It's one of them. Okay, so those of you got 42, check. Is it 48? Those of you got 48, check. Is it 42? Mi pan. I'm addicted to that song, guys. Zuzuzu, zuzuzu. Oh yeah, guys, before I forget, those of you who are done, can you do me a favor? Please like this video, share this video. I see only a few likes, 76 only. There's 134 of you here. Don't be stingy, leh. At least like the video. There's like half of you only who like the video. Come on, like the video at least. Those of you who are a bit more, generous, do me a favor, just share the video, right? That would be great. Then it will be sharing more to more people. All right, let's continue. So the answer, okay, is it 42 or is it 48? All right, so the answer is $48. Okay, so it's not 42, it's $48. Those who got answer correct?
That was easy. Excellent.
Okay, those of you got wrong. Okay, let's listen. Okay, what happened in between? Let's check. So the question says, Chi Seng, by the way, is a friend of mine who's like super, super like close to him. We stay in hall together. Basically, some of you might know, right? I actually am from NUS, you know, National University of Singapore. I stayed in hall for like about 3 years of my life. I mean, I stayed there to study because it's so far away from my home. And Chi Seng was my neighbor, right? So
And it's quite interesting to see his name here. Okay. Has a name, has a number of 10 cent, 20 cents, and 50 cent coins in the ratio of 5:2:1. The total value of all the coins is $168. What is the value of the 20 cent coins? Now, this one, right, guys, those of you who have gone through our My Master Problem Sums program, you would know. You would know that this is what method. Can someone type into the box? What method are we looking at for this one? Okay, so what method are we looking for? We are looking at, yes, that's right, ratio grouping method. Good job. So ratio grouping method is the name of this method. Okay, now let me just make sure that, wait, I need to check the, hold on. Okay, so let me write down first. So it would be 10 cent. Let me write down in a model format, 20 cents and 50 cents. Okay. So 10 cent basically means 5 units, right? So I'm going to do 5 units here. 2 units here. And let's say 1 unit. Eh, why is it not turning? Are you? Technology. Why are you failing on me? Okay, we try one last time. If it doesn't work, then it doesn't work. It's not meant to be a model in its lifespan. This ink. Okay, it's not meant to be a model. Okay, confirm. Okay, so 5 units, 2 units, and 1 unit. Okay, I'm going to put 5, 2, and 1. Okay, make it easy for myself. Now, the total value, right? Okay, let's try imagine, okay? Let's imagine these are 5 coins. Okay, I'm going to make it easy for you to see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So these 2 units should be until here. Okay, 2 units, right? And this is 1 unit, of course, very, very obvious, yeah? So imagine that one of these units represent 1 coin. So how much is the value? So 10 cents times 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That would be 50 cents, right? Then you have 20 cent coins multiplied by 2. That would be 40 cents. And lastly, you got 1 50-cent coin. So that's 50 cents, right? So 50 cents times 1 is just 50 cents. That's self-explanatory, right? So the total value, guys, what is the total value? If this one group, let's imagine this is one group, yeah? This one group, what am I talking about? What's the total value? It's 50 cents plus 40 cents plus 50 cents, right? So the answer is, basically here is $1.40, right? So as a group, this whole thing is only worth $1.40, right? However, you must realize, guys, that the question says the value of the coins is $168. Now, does that match? It doesn't. Now, whenever it doesn't match, we know it's going to be ratio grouping method. Those of you who are in the PSLE intensive program, you should know this, okay, by now. Okay, because we've done this so many times. So, 168 divided by 140. Is it correct? Let me just confirm my working here. Yes, correct. So I'll get 120 groups. So that means what? That means there are 120 of such groups. So what is the total value of the 20 cent coins? The total value of the 20 cent coins is what? 20 cent coins means there's 120 groups of this. So 120 times 2. Eh, wait. Yeah, correct. Because there's 2. No. Times 20 cents, sorry, my mistake. Times 20 cents. No, I'm wrong. Sorry, there's 120 of 40 cents. My mistake, sorry, 40 cents. $48, okay? So that's the answer. The answer is $48. Those of you got the answer correct, good job, awesome. Okay, hold on, something is wrong on my computer. I need to see my comments. I can't see my comments. Okay, I see some people say confused. Okay, what are you all confused about? Can you please type into the box? What are you confused about? Can you type into the box? What are you all confused about? I'll wait for a while, yeah, because there's a lag in the system. So I'm going to wait for a while until you all answer me. What are you all confused about? Then I can explain further. Why do you times 40 cents? Okay, that's the reason, right? Okay, that's the question you're asking for. Thanks so much for liking and sharing the vid, guys. Really appreciate it. I see 100 now. So why 40 cents? Okay, so take a look. And I said, right? I said there are 120 groups, correct? They are asking you for what? The total value of the 20 cent coins. So imagine, right, guys, this one is one 20 cent coin. This is the second 20 cent coin. So as a group, in this group, in one group of these 20 cent coins, there are how many? Two coins, right? Two 20 cent coins will cost me 40 cents. You get it? So that's why if there are 40 cents times 120 groups with the total value, I will take 40 cents times 120. All right, so that's the reason why I do that. Okay, that's the reason why I do that. You'll get it? Please type in, get it, if you understand what I'm saying. Get it? Okay. Okay, Ken, now I'll move on, okay? All right, let's move on. Okay, so, wait, that's it. Okay, so we're going to move on to a different type of question now. Data analysis, yes. Okay, data analysis actually is a question, is a bunch of questions that actually has high marks, but a lot of students still are not able to get it, right? So let me just give you one that looks simple, but actually isn't, okay? Okay, let's start with this one first. This one should be quite simple. No, let's level one. Let's do a level two or level three question. Let me take a look. I need to check this first. Hold on. Give me a second, guys. Let me check first. Okay, this one I remember quite not too bad, actually. Hold on, let me choose for you a good one. Yes, this is a good one, actually. Okay, so let's look at this one. Okay, at first, 1 out of 10 of a tank was filled with water. Okay, let me highlight for you. At first, 1 out of 10 of a tank was filled with water. Okay, now what happened? A tap was turned on for 30 minutes. Okay, for more water to flow into the tank. It was then turned off. Okay, so after that, turn off for 30 minutes, then you turn off. Okay, then the line graph shows the volume of water in the tank over 30 minutes. Okay, very good. So that's the idea here. So what's the question? The question is below, hold on. Okay, wait, before I go to the question, I want you to understand when you look at the data, right, you want to understand a few things. Number one is you want to understand the left, the basically they call it the y-axis, the x-axis on the left. Then you want to look at the x-axis, which is the time. So what this means is this will measure the volume of water over time, right? Volume of water over time. Okay, so that means that when they said that 1/10 of a tank was filled with water, I'm pretty sure you understand by now that this part is 75, right? That means we started with 75 liters. And then we filled up over 30 minutes and we get at the end, we get 225 liters. Okay, so let's go through the question. Part A, how many liters of water flowed into the tank in 1 minute? How many liters of water flowed into the tank in 1 minute? Okay, y'all do part by part, okay? How many liters of water flowed into the tank in 1 minute? Can you answer that one first? Because I can't really like scroll between. If I make it small, y'all will see it's too small, right? She can, I can. Let's give it a shot. So these three questions, A, B, and C. A bit hard to see. Okay, man, you'll try first. If it's too hard to see, let me know. I'll make it bigger again. Oh, this was in your prelims. Wow, interesting. Okay, then you can do part B and part C since I managed to like put it into the question. Okay, I see some of you have done with part B already. Let's do one last one, the part C. Oh, sorry, I've got to tell you, I give you like 4 minutes, okay? So there should be about 2 more minutes, sorry. Just 2 more minutes. If it's very blurry, just click on the bottom right hand corner. There is like a gear button. Click on that, then it will say quality, then change to 720. It will take about 5 minutes, no, a few minutes before it's gonna be clear. One more minute left. Well, that was fast. Okay, I think a lot of you got the answer for part C already, yeah? Okay. Alrighty. Okay, part A, what is the answer? How many liters of water float into the tank in 1 minute? Now, let me show you, right? There are many ways to solve this question. I'll show you the easier method. Now I'll show you another possible method. The first method, right, that I use actually is just look at the first between 0 to 5 minutes. You can see that at zero, it was 75 liters, correct? At 5 minutes, it was what? 100 liters. So that means what, guys? It means that in 5 minutes, I was able to fill up from 75, go to 100. So 100 minus 75 will give me 25 liters. It means that in 5 minutes, I can fill up 25 liters. So in 1 minute, how much can I fill up? Right? The answer will be 25 divided by 5. So the answer will be 5 liters of water float into the tank in 1 minute. So I think a lot of you got the answer correct. Good job. That is simple. That was easy.
That was easy.
That's right. Okay, so let's move on to the next part. Question part B, right? At the end of 30 minutes, what fraction of the tank was filled with water, right? So at the end of 30 minutes. Now, so you've got to be careful because they said the starting was already, remember we said now, it was 1/10 of the tank. So 75 liters represents 1/10 of the tank. Right. Okay. So let's do the calculation first. If 1/10 of the tank was 75 liters, the full tank capacity will be what? 10 out of 10, right? So 75 times 10 will give you 750 liters. But if you recall, at the end, it was only 225. So what fraction of the tank was filled? I just realized that I didn't have my answer sheet open. Let me just quickly open my answer sheet first to make sure that I don't teach the wrong question, the wrong answer. Don't have the right question. Let me check. Oh my goodness me, where is my data analysis answer sheet? Hold on now, guys. Give me a second. I thought I downloaded it. It's not here. Can you do me a favor, guys? Can you tell me what is your answer again for part B? And can you help me calculate what is 225 divided by 70? Because that's the answer. Yeah? So for part B, is 225 divided by 750. What's the fraction? Can you help me calculate, guys? Let me quickly download my answer sheet. Strange. I remember downloading it. Okay, I got it. The answer is Okay, where is it? Ah, there you go. Okay, so the answer would be 3 out of 10. Do you get 3 out of 10, guys? The answer is 3 out of 10. Yes, correct. Thank you very much. So the answer is 3 out of 10 for part B. So a lot of you got the answer as well. Very good.
That was easy. Excellent.
Okay, part C. Now, this I think might be a hard one. The tap was turned on again to fill up the tank at the same rate as before. So what was the rate? The rate before that, remember we said at the first part, it was here, 5 liters per minute. That was the rate. Okay. Now, how many more minutes did it take? Well, actually, not difficult. Actually, quite easy. How many more minutes did it take for the tank to be filled completely? So that would be the complete capacity is 750. It's now at 225. 750 minus 225. What do we get? We will get the answer of 525. So 525 liters. Basically, if it's filled up in 5 liters every minute, it basically you divide by 5. You will get the answer of 105 minutes. Okay, actually quite simple. Sorry. I thought it was a difficult question. All right. Good job, guys. That was something to basically, you know.
That was easy.
To freshen up or refresh. Not refresh. To warm up your brain, I mean. Okay. So let's do something that's slightly more challenging. Okay. Now I know why. I know what happened in between. Okay. I want to see. Where was the one that is quite commonly asked? This one, number 6. This one. Okay, take a look at this one, guys. Commonly asked. A company offered 80 printers at a 25% discount during a 7-day sale. 80 printers, 25% discount, 7-day sale. The line graph shows the number of printers left unsold. Okay, now a lot of people don't read the question. You all have to, I remember, have to read the question. Now, left unsold at the end of each day. Okay, so part A. On which day was the most number of printers sold? Most number of printers sold. Part B. What percentage of the 80 printers were sold in the first 3 days of the sale? Excuse me, percentage of the 80 printers. Part C, during the sale, the discounted price of the printers was 120. Okay, so discounted price during the sale was 120. After the sale, the remaining printers were sold without a discount. After sale, remaining sold without discount. What was the total amount of money collected from selling all 80 printers? Okay, so please give it a shot. Listen, I'll give you about 4 minutes. Give it a shot. So for the first one, some of you say day one, some of you say day two, some of you say day seven. Which one is it? Which one? This one is it paper two? Let me check for you. Hold on. This is paper two, yes. So you may use a calculator, no problemo. Can you all try part B also, please? Part B. Okay, some say day one, some say day two, some say day seven. That's interesting. Some people are saying day seven. Mm-hmm. Meepan, Zuzuzu, Zuzuzu. Oh no, it's back, guys. Meepan. Meepan, Yagakus, Nam Nam Nam. You got about 1 more minute. 1 more minute. Starting to sound like a radio DJ. Oof, I see some people got an answer for part C as well. Good job, good job. Very good, very good. So far, but see, I don't see any answers correct. Such a big number someone got. Yes, Adrian, I have a Meepan virus. Yes. For part C, they asked for total amount of money collected from selling all 80. So that means some of them are the one on offer, some of them are the one at the original price, guys. All right, thumbs up. Thumbs up. Okay, so let's give it a shot. The first one, day one, day two, or day seven? A lot of you say day one, day two, day seven. I don't know which one is which. Okay, the answer is... Where's my drum roll? Where's my drum roll? Alamak, where's my drum roll? Okay, here, here, here. Okay. Ready, set, drum roll. Answer is... Day two. Okay, the answer is day two, guys. Now, so if some of you said day one and versus day seven. Now, I don't understand why some of you says it day seven. Okay, now, I think I know why, actually. Let me explain to you first, okay? Now, these line graphs, right, are the ones that are the most troublesome, okay? The rest of them are quite simple. So, I suspect why some of you said day seven is because you thought, oh, wait a minute. Every single day they sell 80, at the end they are only left with 4, right? Oh, that means they sold 76 on day 7. And okay, wait, I got the buzzer. Okay, so it's not like that. That would be if it was basically a bar graph, right? So what this means is actually at the start of the sale there were 80 printers. Then as the sale went by, let's say by the end of day one, right, it dropped to how many left? 64. You see what I mean? It dropped to 64. By the end of day two, it dropped to 40. So from 80 sold to 40. So it's still half ready. By the end of day three, what happened? Yeah, at 28, right? Then by the end of day four, we reached 20. The end of day five, we reached 16. By the end of day six, we reached... how much is that? 12. By the end of day 7, we reach 4. So basically, it's the declining number, right? It's going down. Now, on which day was the most number of printers sold? Now, let me teach you a trick. The trick to this, right, guys, is that you got to look for the triangle that is, the biggest triangle. Put it this way. So from the start of the sale to day 1, so what happened? It dropped by this much. From day 1 to day 2, what happened? So you see, like that, it dropped all the way until here. That is bigger, right? The triangle. Okay, now I'm just going to keep drawing the triangles until you see what I mean. Okay. So if I ask you, right, which is the one that has the least number of sales? Remember, this is N of each day, guys. N of each day. So some of you are confused. Is it day one or day two? So you see, yeah, this is by the end of day one, I actually have 64 left. That means I have sold 16. By the end of day two, right, I've got 40 left. So I've sold 24. You see that? So when I say by the end of day two, it means what, guys? it means that I have sold it in day two. And by the end of day two, when I check my stocks, I realize, hey, wait a minute, I've sold 24. So the answer is not day one. The answer is day two. Do you get it? If you get it, please type in. I get it. Let me check your comments to ensure that you all understand what I'm talking about. Very high. It's over 9,000.
It's over 9,000!
Okay. So remember, guys, you got to remember that it is actually talking about by the end of day two. Okay. You got it? Huh? Okay. Awesome. Okay. Part B. What percentage of the 80 printers were sold in the first 3 days of the sale? So now you should know already, right? By the end of day three, I have sold. I'm left with 28, sorry. So how many have I sold? Right? So I've sold 80 minus 28. So 80, I write here, okay, for part B. 80 minus 28, I have sold altogether 52. Now, what percentage of the 80 printers? So out of 80, 52 out of 80 times 100%. What's the answer? The answer is 65%. I saw a lot of you got this answer. Good job. So answer is correct.
That was easy.
That's like a really popular movie back then. Rocky Balboa. All right. So part C, during the sale, the discounted price of the printers was $120. After the sale, however, the remaining printers were sold without a discount. No. So how do we know what is the price without the discount, right? So I saw this answer. Some of you got like really, really huge numbers, like 23,000 or something. So let's go through, okay? 25% discount means that they basically give it at a quarter, at a three-quarter of the price, right? So give you a quarter discount. And that was $120. So that means that 75%, okay, I got no space, I'm going to write here, okay? 75% must be equal to $120. So what is 100%? What is the original price? That will be 120 divided by 75 times 100, right? I got no space, I'm sorry. So the answer to that would be the price would be actually $160 if there were no discount, right? If there's no discount. So how many did she sell at the end, right? Remember, at the end of the sale, there were four left over. Remember this? There's four left over. So these four were sold at the price of 160, right? Make sense? So I'll do is 4 times 160, giving me the answer of 640. Okay. Then don't forget, there's still the 76 that I sold. Where did I get 76 from? Because 80 minus 4. So I sold 76 at the sale itself, which is 76 times $120, which will give me $9,120. So altogether now, I just have to plus the values together. So 9120. Plus 640, the answer would be 9760. That is the final answer. Those of you got the answer correct, good job. Awesome.
That was easy.
That was easy. Okay, very good. Okay, we are done with this one, right? So, let's move on. Okay, let me see. Is there any more that I want to go through? Hold on, let me just quickly check. Okay, I think that's pretty much it. Okay, for the line graphs, the rest of them are quite easy. There's nothing else that I want to go through. Yeah, there's nothing else I want to go through. Okay, so let me move on to the final one for the week. That's three topics down, right? Percentage, data analysis, whole numbers, circles. Circles, I think quite simple. Let me try composite. No, actually, I've gone through this one also. Duration. Okay, tell you what, let's go through circles. Okay, I think we've only got enough time for one question anyway. The one that I want to go through is... Okay, those of you who already did this in class in the present intensive, you will know how to do it, right? But I think this one is an important one to go through. Okay, this one is an important one. Okay, let's give it a shot, guys. The figure shows a path of width 2 meters in a rectangular garden of length 28 meters. So the length we know is going to be 28 meters. Meters, sorry. Why am I talking like an American? 28 meters. That would be a British, okay? So the width is 2 meters. So that means this part, the width is 2 meters. The outline of the path is made up of quarter circles, a quarter circles with center W, center W, semicircles with center Z, and straight lines. So there's a straight line over there, right? Straight lines. So WX equals to YZ. Very important. They said WX equals to YZ. Part A, what is the width of the rectangular garden? Width also means what? Breadth, yeah? It also means breadth. Width means breadth. And part B, what is the area? Find the area of the path. Take pi as 3.14. So this one you can use calculator. No problemo. Let me see how many marks this is. I can't remember already. 4 marks. Okay. So let's give you about 5 minutes, Ken. Give it a shot. Let's go. Last question for the day. Can we lose half mark if we combine steps? Because I was rewarded half mark when I combine my steps. I think it depends, right? You said, can we lose half mark if we combine steps? Because we rewarded half mark. So I'm guessing that you lost half mark, right? So I think the idea is that if your answer is wrong at the end, right, and you basically skip steps, then you most probably will lose the half mark because the teacher doesn't see that step. So that's why I always tell my students, don't skip steps. Even if it's a simple thing, just write down. Because you never know if your answer is wrong at the end, right? They can still give you like method marks in between. Okay, so I see some answers. I think this question came out for my prelim. Wow, okay, that's cool. Da, 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 da. Wow, so fast, some of you got answered already. That was really fast. Y'all find it easy, is it? I thought it's quite challenging. Eh? That's good, that's good. Those of you who are still doing, you got about 2 minutes. Please go, Shakir, no problem. Do I have to ask for my permission? You can go, no problem. All right, I think almost everyone is done, right? You got 1 more minute, those of you are still doing. I'm seeing some answers for part A. I think a lot of you find it easy. Part B is the one that have problems. Some of you have problems. Alrighty. Let's go. Okay, come. Let's go through the question. Okay, so the answer for the first one is correct. A lot of you got the answer. The answer is 20 meters. Okay, so how do you find that? It's very simple. Just take a look at this one. You must understand that the length is 28 meters, right? So that means from here all the way until here, that's 28 meters. Okay, now, why is that important? Because we know that, you see, there is one quadrant over here. Quadrant means quarter circle, right? One quadrant. There are two quadrants. And of course, there's a third quadrant over here. So altogether, there are three quadrants. Three quadrants means three quarter of a circle. Yeah. So we also, that also means that we got three. Oi. That also means that we've got three radius, right? Three radii. We call it radii, right? Plus, we also have that, don't forget, we still got that 2 meters, remember? So we've got 2 meters over here and 2 meters over here. Now, with that in mind, what we can do is we can find the radius, right? So step one, if we minus off these 2 meters and these 2 meters from the 28, what happens is we will get the radius of, so we get 3 radii or a 3 radius, right? So 28 minus 2 minus 2 will give you 24 meters. 24 meters divided by 3 will give you the radius, which is 8 meters, right? So what is the width of the rectangular garden? So you see from here to here, we now know that the radius is how much? It's 8. Don't forget this part is 2, right? 2 meters, because that's the width of the garden. So that's one half. The other half from here to here, you see, is 8. So we got the part over here is also 2. So we know it's going to be 2. So all together is 8 plus 2 times 2, right? So the answer is 8 plus 2 times 2. Or you can do 8 plus 2 plus 8 plus 2 equals to the answer of 20 meters. So a lot of you got the answer correct for that one. Good job. All right. So that was easy.
That was easy.
Now, for the second one, some of you, a lot of you got the answer correct too, which is great, but I know some of you are really struggling with this one. Okay, so I will explain the part B. Find the area of the path. Okay, so what's the answer first? The answer is 104.78 square meters. 104.78 square meters. Those of you got the answer correct, good job. All right, so let's do part B together. Find the area of the path. Now, to do this question, right, guys, what we need to do is we need to, let me just quickly erase all of these things, realize that this thing is made up of three shapes. The first shape is this one, right? Are you? Okay, now, how do I get this shaded part? What I need to do, guys, is take the big quadrant or the big quarter circle minus off the small quarter circle. Minus of the small quarter circle, this one. You get it? So if I take the big quarter circle minus the small quarter circle, I will just get this shaded part, right? And if you realize, there's three of them. One, there's two over here, there's three over here. So all I need to do is find one of them that I times three, right? That I get all these parts that I'm coloring right now. And the last thing I need to find is the rectangle over here, which is going to be easy to find, right? Okay, let's find the rectangle first. It's easier, right? So from here to here, we know it's 10, right? 8 plus 2, that's 10 meters. Then we know that the width of this thing is 2 meters, so that's going to be 2. So we know for certain that this rectangle, this rectangular part, the area of rectangle here is equal to, sorry, handwriting is horrible, 10 times 2, which is 20 square meters. Part 1, done. Then all we need to do now is find this times 3, right? So we take the area of the big quadrant, area of big quadrant minus the area of small quadrant. It's minus small quadrant, okay? So what's the big quadrant formula? A quarter, don't forget, a quarter times pi r squared, 3.14 times radius. What's the radius here? Remember the big one, the radius is going to be 10. The small one, the radius is going to be 2, right? So I'm going to take 10 times 10. Okay, bracket, this whole thing is the big one. Minus a quarter times 3.14 times 8 times 8. That's the smaller one, right? Then I will get the answer of 28.26 square meters. Okay, that's one of them. Don't forget, we've got three of these. 1, 2, and 3. So we have to multiply this by 3. So 28.26 times 3. And then we plus, don't forget, you got to plus the rectangle over here, which is the 20 meters, 20 square meters. So we plus 20 equal to 104.78 square meters. Voila. We are done. Good job to all of you.
That was easy. Excellent. It's over 9,000.
All right, so can zoom up. Okay, screenshot. Okay, hold on. I zoom up for you. You'll see. You can't see part B. Okay, hold on. Hold on. Okay, so I let you. I zoom up for you first. Those of you need to copy down, please carry on. All right, and we are done. Woohoo! Good job. So to celebrate for all of you, good job. Hey, no, wrong song. Yeah. Thank you very much, guys. I think that will be the end. I hope you enjoyed this lesson. Please do me a favor. If you haven't liked it and share it, please go and like and share it. Okay, so remember, it's very close to the PSLE. Work harder. Aim higher. You can definitely do a lot better than what you think. Do your best. And thank you so much for joining us today. All right? So I'm going to end the class today. As usual, can you all say bye-bye? Bye-bye. Say bye. Thank you. Okay, guys. Have a good one. I'll see you next week.